So, dear students, this class I am going to continue the trigonometry part. That's what we will call specially this one as multiple and submultiple angles. Why we are calling this one as multiples and submultiple angles? That also we are going to discuss now. Come on, let's participate in the discussion. As I told to you people earlier class also, we discussed so many formulas based on sin a plus b, sin a minus b, cos a plus b, cos a minus b. Today's class also we are going to derive the formulas based on that particular formula. Let us see, you know the formula for sin a plus b. Sin a plus b formula is sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. That is the formula for sin a plus b formula. Sin a plus b is equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. And at the same time, you know the formula for cos of a plus b also. Tell me, what is the formula for cos of a plus b? Cos of a plus b is equal to cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. This is the formula for cos of a plus b. Now based on these formulas, I am going to discuss a few more formulas. Come on. Here what I am doing first here is, in place of b, I am writing a. B is replaced by a. Then what happens? Sin a plus a is equals to sin a plus cos a sin a. Agree or not? Now sin a plus a means you will get sin 2a. That sin 2a is equals to 2 sin a cos a. That is the formula for sin 2a. Sin 2a we can write it as 2 sin a cos a. Right? Same here what I am going to do, observe here. This we can write it as 2 times sin a divided by cos a into 1 by secant square a. Followed or not? Multiplied with cos a, divided with cos a, divided with cos a, multiplied with cos a. Cos square a can be written as 1 by secant square a. Now sin a by cos a we can write it as tan a. Secant square a can be written as 1 plus tan square a. That's why this one changes as 2 tan a divided by 1 plus tan square a. This is the formula for sin 2a formula in terms of tan. Sin 2a is equals to 2 tan a divided by 1 plus tan square a. Sin 2a is equal to 2 sin a cos a. Sin 2a is equal to 2 tan a by 1 plus tan square a. This is the formula in terms of tan. Okay. So now if you know sin 2a formula, how to write sin a formula? Observe here, what I am doing now in the same formula, 2a is replaced with alpha. 2a is replaced with alpha. Then what will get? Sin alpha. Array, whenever 2a is replaced with alpha, in place of a, what we have to write? 2a is equal to alpha implies you will get a is equal to alpha by 2. Now because of this information, this formula changes as sin alpha is equals to 2 sin alpha by 2 into cos alpha by 2. Right? So that means sin 2a is equal to 2 sin a cos a, whereas sin alpha is equal to 2 sin alpha by 2 cos alpha by 2. This is multiples and submultiples. That is the reason we are calling it as multiple and submultiple angles. Let us see here, sin 2a is equal to 2 tan a by 1 plus tan square a. Now can you tell me what we have to write sin alpha formula in terms of tan? That is equals to 2 tan alpha by 2 divided by 1 plus tan square alpha by 2. So sin alpha is equals to 2 tan alpha by 2 by 1 plus tan square alpha by 2. That's why if you know sin 2a formula, sin 2a formula in terms of tan, if you know these formulas, there is no need to remember these formulas specially based on this information only. Right? So another formula, cos a plus b. Here also I am replacing b with a. B is replaced by a. Then what we will get? Cos of a plus a is equals to cos a into cos a minus sin a into sin a. That we can write it as cos square a minus sin square a. So cos 2a formula is cos square a minus sin square a. So we got the information cos 2a is equal to cos square a minus sin square a. Cos 2a is equal to cos square a minus sin square a. Okay, this is the formula for cos 2a. Suppose I want to find out the formula for cos 2a exclusively in terms of sine. What I am saying? In terms of sine. Then what to do here? We required the formula in terms of sine. That's why cos square a can be written as 1 minus sin square a minus sin square a. Right? So then what we will get? 1 minus sin square a minus sin square a. So this becomes 1 minus 2 sin square a. So that's why that is the another formula for cos 2a in terms of sin. Cos 2a is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square a. Suppose the same cos 2a formula exclusively you have to get in terms of cos. Cos 2a formula in terms of cos. Then what to do? This here in place of sin square a. Here in place of sin square a, I am writing 1 minus cos square a. Now what about the simplification? That simplification you will get 2 cos square a minus 1. That's why cos 2a formula is cos square a minus sin square a. If you want in terms of sin, 1 minus 2 sin square a. If you want in terms of cos, 2 cos square a minus 1. So that's why another way we can write cos 2a is equal to 2 cos square a minus 1. Now here sin 2a formula we got in terms of tan. Let us derive cos 2a formula also in terms of tan. So further what I am doing, observe here. Here numerator and denominator I am dividing with in this formula. Numerator and denominator, the first formula, numerator and denominator divide with the cos square a. That means multiply with the cos square a, divide with the cos square a. Then what happens? Cos square a minus sin square a divided by cos square a into 1 by secant square a. I hope so followed. Because multiplied with the cos square a, divided with the cos square a. So cos square a can be written as 1 by secant square a. Now here what happens? This becomes 1 minus tan square a. Because cos cancel 1, sin square a divided by cos square a is a tan square a. At the same time, this secant square a can be written as 1 plus tan square a. So that's why cos 2a formula in terms of tan is 1 minus tan square a divided by 1 plus tan square a. So cos 2a we have different formulas. The first formula is cos square a minus sin square a. The next formula is 1 minus 2 sin square a. And another formula is 2 cos square a minus 1. Just now we derived the another formula in terms of tan, that is 1 minus tan square a divided by 1 plus tan square a. Now you can observe here cos 2a is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square a. From this I am going to discuss another idea here. What is 1 minus cos 2a? And from this another idea I am going to discuss. Cos 2a can be written in another way as cos 2a is equals to 1 plus cos 2a. What we can write? Observe that from this formula only. We got here cos 2a is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square a. This is 2 sin square a shift to that side. Cos 2a bring to this side. You will get 1 minus cos 2a. That's why 1 minus cos 2a we can write it as 2 sin square a. In a similar way, this minus 1 shifted to that side. You will get 1 plus cos 2a is equal to 2 cos square a. So 1 minus cos 2a is equal to 2 sin square a, whereas 1 plus cos 2a is equal to 2 cos square a. Very very important formulas. The entire second year also, plus 2 also, we are going to use these formulas. You have to learn, you have to buy out these formulas. 1 minus cos 2a is equal to 2 sin square a. 1 plus cos 2a is equal to 2 cos square a. That is about multiples. Now we will discuss the same with the help of submultiples. What I discussed here, 2a is equal to alpha, then a is equal to alpha by 2. Now tell me what we can write cos alpha formula. Cos alpha we can write it as cos square alpha by 2 minus sin square alpha by 2. Right? Now tell me here what we can write. 1 minus cos alpha. Come on. 1 minus cos alpha what we can write? 1 minus cos alpha we can write it as 2 sin square alpha by 2. Tell me what we can write. 1 plus cos alpha. Yes. 1 plus cos alpha we can write it as 2 cos square alpha by 2. Now tell me what is the formula for cos alpha in terms of tan. Cos alpha formula in terms of tan is 1 minus tan square alpha by 2 divided by 1 plus tan square alpha by 2. This is the formula for cos alpha in terms of tan. So that's why specially no need to remember these formulas. If you know these formulas thoroughly, then we can remember these things easily. We can write easily if you know these formulas. Okay. So that is about cos 2a and sin 2a formulas. Everyone know the formula for tan a plus b. What is the tan a plus b formula? If you know tan a plus b formula, then we can discuss tan 2a formula also. You know this one. Tan a plus b is equals to, come on, tan of a plus b is equal to tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b. That is the formula for tan of a plus b. Tan a plus b is equal to tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a tan b. Now here also b is replaced with a. If you are replacing b with a, what happens? Tan of a plus a is equals to tan a plus tan a divided by 1 minus tan a into tan a. So that's why we are getting tan 2a is equals to 2 tan a divided by 1 minus tan square a. That is tan 2a formula in terms of tan. Sin 2a formula we got in terms of tan. 2 tan a by 1 plus tan square a. Cos 2a formula we got in terms of tan. 1 minus tan square a by 1 plus tan square a. Now we got tan 2a formula in terms of tan. That is 2 tan a divided by 1 minus tan square a. So these are the 2a formulas. In the similar way, we are going to discuss 3a formulas also. Let us discuss here sin 3a. For that, first of all, sin a plus b formula is equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. That is sin a plus b formula. Now what I am doing here is b is replaced with 2a, because I am saying that sin 3a formulas. That's why in place of b I am writing 2a. If b is replaced by 2a, what we will get? This is sin a plus 2a, right, is equals to sin a into cos 2a plus cos a into sin 2a. Wherever b is there, in place of b I have written 2a. Now what it becomes? This is sin 3a, left hand side. Sin 3a is equal to sin a into, I am writing cos 2a formula in terms of sin. Come on, tell me what is the formula for cos 2a in terms of sin. Just now we discussed it. Cos 2a formula in terms of sin is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square a plus cos a into, you know the formula for sin 2a, that also we discussed just now in terms of sin 2a formula is 2 sin a cos a. Okay, so sin 3a formula we are going to derive. That's why try to get sin 3a exclusively in terms of sin. So wherever cos terms are there, wherever cos terms are there, try to convert them into sin. Then observe here, this is equals to sin a minus 2 times sin cube a, right, plus 2 sin a into cos square a can be written as 1 minus sin square a. Cos square a can be written as 1 minus sin square a. Now this simplification you will get sin a minus 2 times sin cube a plus 2 sin a minus 2 times sin cube a. Now the simplification we will get 3 sin a minus 4 sin cube a. Therefore we got sin 3a is equal to 3 sin a minus 4 sin cube a. Sin 3a is equal to 3 sin a minus 4 sin cube a. Suppose in a similar way, if I substitute 3a is equal to alpha, then what is a? A is equal to alpha by 3. Now tell me what is sin alpha, we can write. Sin alpha is equal to 3 into sin alpha by 3 minus 4 into sin cube alpha by 3. That's what we will call it as multiples and submultiple angles. Sin 3a formula is 3 sin a minus 4 sin cube a. In the similar way, we can also discuss the formula for cos 3a. Cos 3a is equal to 4 cos cube a minus 3 times cos a. In a similar way, we can write the formula for tan 3a also we can derive. Tan 3a is equal to 3 tan a minus tan cube a divided by 1 minus 3 times tan square a. So these are the formulas for sin 2a, cos 2a, tan 2a. And now sin 3a, cos 3a, tan 3a formulas. If you know this formula of sin 3a, these type of informations we can write. Right? So this is about the discussion regarding sin 2a, cos 2a, tan 2a formulas. Sin 3a, cos 3a, tan 3a formulas, those are nothing but multiples and submultiple angles formulas involved. So based on this information, just I want to discuss a few questions here. All of you pay attention here. So first of all, I'll try to discuss the questions whatever is there in the textbook, from our textbook. You know, this is the first question given. The question is given as sin 2x. So this is question number 14 in the third exercise. Sin 2x plus 2 sin 4x plus 2 sin 4x plus sin 6x plus sin 6x is equals to, is asking to show 4 times cos square x into sin 4x. Okay, so last class we discussed what is the formula for sin c plus sin d. Tell me what is the formula for sin c plus sin d. Sin c plus sin d is equals to 2 times sin c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d divided by 2. I hope so everyone know this formula. Based on this formula only we are going to discuss the problem. Observe here 2 times sin 4x is there. But if you apply this formula sin c plus sin d, 2x plus 6x, 8x r naught, 8x by 2, 4x r naught. That's why what I am doing, observe here, 2 times sin 4x plus sin 6x plus sin 2x. Now I am taking these two as a group, right? Now we can write this one as 2 times sin 4x plus, apply sin c plus sin d formula. Sin c plus sin d is, see there, sin c plus sin d formula is 2 sin c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d divided by 2. So what about the simplification? We can write that one as 2 times sin 4x plus, here also you will get 2 times sin 4x, here cos 2x. Now what we can take common here? We can take 2 times sin 4x common. If you take 2 sin 4x common, we will get 1 plus cos 2x. Right? Just now I discussed the formula for 1 plus cos 2a. 1 plus cos 2a is equal to 2 cos square a we discussed at the same time. That time only I told 1 minus cos 2a, we can write it as 2 sin square a. But 1 plus cos 2a, we can write it as 2 cos square a. Now this is 1 plus cos 2x, we can write that one as 2 sin 4x into 1 plus cos 2x, we can write it as 2 cos square x. That is the reason we will get the answer as 4 cos square x into sin 4x is the answer. It completely depends on the formulas. How effectively you know the formulas, that much effectively we can work out the problems in a proper way. Let us see another question. The question is given like this. This is question number 15, I can say. Cot 4x. It is a cot 4x into sin 5x plus a sin 3x. Sin 5x plus a sin 3x is equals to, he is asking to do cot x into sin 5x minus sin 3x, he is asking. Okay, first of all let us do a simplification of left hand side. Left hand side simplification I am doing here. That is a cot 4x into, here sin c plus sin d formula just now we applied. Sin c plus sin d formula is 2 times sin c plus d divided by 2 into cos c minus d divided by 2. That is the formula for sin c plus sin d. Now we can write that one further as cos 4x divided by sin 4x into, come on, that simplification we can write it as 2 times sin 4x, right, into, here you will get cos x. Now sin 4x, sin 4x cancel, we are getting this one as cos x, I am writing outside, into 2 times cos 4x. That's what we got. Sir, why you are writing cos x outside? That's what, when you are doing the simplification, you have to think about the right hand side. What we have to get the answer? Right hand side, what is there? Cot x is there. Cot x is nothing but cos x by sin x, or not? Yes, cos x is there. We require sin x. That's why multiply with the sin x, divide with the sin x. This is equals to cos x divided by sin x into 2 times cos 4x into sin x. Right? So multiplied with the sin x, divided with the sin x. 2 cos 4x into sin x. Observe here, sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b formula we discussed in the last video. 2 sin a cos b, or otherwise sin of a plus b minus sin of a minus b, also we discussed the formula as 2 cos a sin b, right? So that's what we can write this one as. This is equals to cot x 2 cos a sin b. 2 cos a sin b, we can write this one as sin a plus b minus sin a minus b over. This is sin 5x and this is sin 3x. That's what we have to get. So it depends completely on how, what type of formulas you know, what he is asking to prove, right? So just simply without thinking about the answer what we have to get, you are doing the simplification, means no use. We have to think always what type of answer we have to get, what he is asking right hand side. In that direction we have to think and then we have to apply the formula. Let us see, the other question is given like this. So this is question number 21 in the book given. Cos 4x plus cos 3x plus cos 2x divided by sin 4x plus sin 3x plus sin 2x is equals to, he is asking to show cot 3x, right? Now how I am doing the simplification, observe. Cot 3x, we have to get the answer. Cot 3x is nothing but cos 3x by sin 3x. Definitely we have to get cos 3x common in the numerator. sin 3x we have to get common in the denominator. That is the idea in your mind. Cos 3x we have to get common in the numerator. Sin 3x we have to get. Cos by sin you will get caught as an answer. Right? So observe here. Cos 4x plus cos 2x plus cos 3x divided by sin 4x plus sin 2x plus sin 3x. That is the manipulation I did. Now we can apply numerator cos c plus cos d formula. What is the formula for cos c plus cos d? Cos c plus cos d is equals to 2 times cos c plus d divided by 2 into cos c minus d divided by 2. Similarly, you know the formula for sin c plus sin d also. Sin c plus sin d is equals to 2 sin c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d divided by 2. That is cos c plus cos d formula, sin c plus sin d formula. Come on, apply here. That is equals to 2 times cos c plus d divided by 2 into cos c minus d divided by 2. 4x minus 2x by 2, 2x by 2x plus cos 3x. Similarly, denominator apply sin c plus sin d formula. 2 sin c plus d divided by 2 into sin cos c minus d divided by 2 plus sin 3x. The problem is over. Numerator we can take cos 3x common. Then we will get 2 cos x plus 1. Denominator we have to take sin 3x common. If you take sin 3x common, here also you get 2 cos x plus 1. Numerator denominator cancel. Cos by sin is equals to cot. That is the way to approach this particular question. So let's have a discussion of another question. The question is given in this way. This is the question. Cot x, this is question number 20. 2. Cot x into cot 2x minus cot 2x into cot 3x minus cot 3x into cot x is equals to, is asking to show 1. Right? So that is the question. Cot x into cot 2x minus cot 2x into cot 3x minus cot 3x into cot x is equals to 1 we have to show. Observe all the terms x, 2x, 3x, x, 2x, 3x involved. That's why what I am doing is, so 3x can be written as 2x plus x. Y's are like that. Yes, you can write 3x minus x can be written as 2x, or otherwise you can write, so 3x minus 2x is equals to x. Anyway, you can approach and then apply both sides cot. Therefore, cot 3x is equals to cot 2x plus x. The problem is over if you know the formula for cot a plus b. What is the formula for cot a plus b? Cot a plus b formula is cot a cot b minus 1 divided by cot b plus cot a. That is the formula for cot a plus b. Cot a plus b formula, cot a cot b minus 1 by cot b plus cot a. Now cross multiply, you will get cot 3x into cot 2x plus cot 3x into cot x. Cot 3x into cot 2x plus cot 3x into cot x is equals to cot 2x into cot x minus 1. Okay. Now this particular term shift to this side and minus 1 transferred to the left hand side, you will get the required answer. Check. Cot x into cot 2x, cot 2x into cot 3x minus cot 3x into cot x is equals to 1 you will get. Shift these two terms to that side, minus 1 shift to this side. That is the question what he is asking. Okay. So another question you can see here. This is also the question from the textbook only. This is asking question number 23. He is saying that tan 4x is equals to 4 into tan x is multiplied with 1 minus tan square x divided by 1 minus 6 into tan square x plus tan x whole to the power of 4. That is equals to tan 4x. Tan 4x is equals to, we have to show that one. So nothing difficulty here. What I am doing it is tan 4x I am writing it as tan 2 into 2x. Tan 4x we are writing it as tan 2 into 2x. Now you know the formula for tan 2a. What is the formula for tan 2a in terms of tan? Tan 2a is equals to 2 tan a divided by 1 minus tan square a. That is the formula for tan 2a. That's why apply tan 2a. Tan 2a formula is equals to 2 tan a divided by 1 minus tan square a. In place of a, we have 2x is there. That's why 4x can be written as 2 into 2x. It is the formula of tan 2a. Tan 2a can be written as 2 tan a by 1 minus tan square a. Now this is equals to 2 into, again apply tan 2x formula, 2 tan x divided by 1 minus tan square x whole divided by 1 minus 2 tan x by 1 minus tan square x whole square. So wherever tan 2x is there, in place of tan 2x, I applied the formula again. Now we can write this simplification further as 4 tan x divided by 1 minus tan square x whole divided by 1 minus tan square x whole square minus 4 tan square x whole divided by 1 minus tan square x whole square. Just take an LCM. Here 1 minus tan square x, here 1 minus tan square x whole square, one time cancel, you will get 4 tan x into 1 minus tan square x divided by, here a minus b o square formula, a square plus b square minus, here 2 times, here minus 4 times, total it becomes 6 times tan square x. Okay, so that is the way of doing this particular question. Nothing is there. We applied tan 2a formula. Tan 2a is equals to 2 tan a divided by 1 minus tan square a. That formula application question, that one. Next we have another question. Cos 6x is equals to, he is asking to show 32 into cos x whole to the power of 6 minus 48 into cos x whole to the power of 4 minus plus 18 into cos square x minus 1. Cos 2x is equals to 32 into cos x whole power 6 minus 48 into cos x whole to the power of 4 plus 18 into cos square x minus 1. Okay, now observe here. We are going to apply the formula for, yes, so that means we can write like this also, 2 into 3x. 6x can be written as cos 2 into 3x. Now tell me, what is the formula for cos 2a? Cos 2a formula in terms of cos. Cos 2a formula in terms of cos. This is the formula. Cos 2a is equals to 2 cos square a minus 1. Cos 2a formula is 2 cos square a minus 1. That's why cos 2a formula is 2 cos square a minus 1. Then the problem is over. This we can write it as 2 into, what is the formula for cos 3x? Cos 3x formula is 4 cos cube x minus 3 cos x whole square minus 1. Because minus 1 we already got. you know a minus b o square formula, you will get the answer. That is equals to 2 into, come on, tell me a minus b o square formula, a square, right, minus 2 into a into b, a square minus 2ab term plus b square minus 1. Come on, 2 multiply inside, you will get the answer. 32 into cos x whole to the power of 6. 2 2s are 4, 4 4s are 16, 16 3s are 48. That's why minus 48 into cos x whole to the power of 4. Next 2 9s are 18 plus 18 into cos square x, that outside minus 1. That is about cos 6x formula, whatever he is asking, BT. Next, another question we can see here. Sin x whole to the power of 4 plus cos x whole to the power of 4 is equals to 1 minus 2 sin square x cos square x. Another one is sin x whole to the power of 6 plus cos x whole to the power of 6 is equal to 1 minus 3 sin square x into cos square x. So these are the questions. This is the question from the book only. This is another question given. Try to remember these as a formulas for objective exams. Okay, how to write this one, how to prove? Observe here. Sin x whole power 4 can be written as sin square x whole square plus cos square x whole square. Enough. If you know a square plus b square formula, come on, tell me what is the formula for a square plus b square. A square plus b square is equal to a plus b whole square minus 2ab. A square plus b square is equal to a plus b whole square minus 2ab. A square plus b square formula, a plus b whole square minus 2ab. Sin square x plus cos square x is equals to 1 minus 2 times sin square x into cos square x. That's what, that is the requirement. Whereas here also seen, what are sin square x whole cube plus cos square x whole cube. If you know a cube plus b cube formula, yes, a cube plus b cube can be written as a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. A cube plus b cube can be written as a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. That's why we can write this one as a plus b whole cube. That is sin square x plus cos square x whole cube. That is a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b sin square x plus cos square x. A cube plus b cube can be written as a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. This value is equals to 1. This value is also 1. So we are getting the answer as 1 minus 3 sin square x cos square x. So sin x whole power 4 plus cos x whole power 4, we can write it as 1 minus 2 sin square x cos square x. Whereas if 6 is their power, we can write 1 minus 3 sin square x cos square x. So let's have a discussion of another question. This is the question from the miscellaneous exercise. The question is given like this. 2 times cos pi by 13 cos 9 pi by 13 plus cos 3 pi by 13 plus cos 5 pi by 13 is equal to 0, we have to show. For that, we have to know the formula for 2 times cos A cos B. What is the formula for 2 cos A cos B? Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Now apply that one. 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos of A plus B 10 pi by 13 plus cos of A minus B 8 pi by 13. A plus B, A minus B. Sorry, A minus B, if you take minus 8 pi by 13, you will get no issue. Cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. That's why. Right. So, 2 cos A cos B formula. Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Here, this one I am not disturbing. 3 pi by 13 plus cos of 5 pi by 13. Any idea? Yes, this can be written as cos of. Come on. This we can write it as here 8 pi by 13, here 5 pi by 13. Here 10 pi by 13, here 3 pi by 13. What I am doing? Observe here. Come on, anyone? So that we can write it as 10 pi by 13 plus cos 8 pi by 13. Here what I am doing? Observe here. Cos pi minus 3 pi by 10 pi by 13 pi minus 10 pi 3 pi or not 13 pi minus 10 pi 3 pi or not. At the same time, the second part also we can do in this way, plus cos of pi minus 8 pi by 13. Here we got 10 pi by 13. Here we got 8 pi by 13. Observe there. So 3 pi by 13 we can write in this way. 5 pi by 13 we can write in this way. Because 13 pi minus 8 pi is 5 pi. Now this is equals to cos 10 pi by 13 plus cos 8 pi by 13. What about cos 180 minus theta? Cos 180 minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. That's why you will get minus cos 10 pi by 13. Here also cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. That's why you will get minus cos 8 pi by 13. So minus cos, here plus cos cancel, here cancel, cancel. You get the answer as 0. That's what he is asking to show, 0. So another question we are discussing here. The question is like this. So very difficult question I can say, but so easy to work out. Let us see that this question I am discussing. Tan x is equal to minus 4 by 3 given. Tan x is equal to minus 4 by 3. And x lies in second quadrant. X lies in second quadrant. Then he is asking to find the value of sin x by 2, cos x by 2, tan x by 2. Very good. Tan x is equal to minus 4 by 3 given, and x lies in second quadrant. Then what is the value of sin x by 2, cos x by 2, tan x by 2? That is the question. Nothing difficulty in this question. Only you have to know this formula. 1 minus cos x is equals to 2 sin square x by 2. 1 plus cos x is equals to 2 cos square x by 2. Because after discussion of cos 2x formula, cos 2x formula, I discussed these informations. 1 minus cos x we can write 2 sin square x by 2. 1 plus cos x we can write it as 2 cos square x by 2. If you know this information, then we can do the question in a proper way. That's enough. Observe here. Tan x is equal to minus 4 by 3 given. X lies in second quadrant. X is there in second quadrant. X is there in second quadrant. But what about x by 2? X by 2. Are a second quadrant means what? 90 less than x less than 180. That is the second quadrant. X lies in second quadrant given. Now, what about x by 2? Pi by 4 less than x by 2 less than pi by 2. That's the information we got. X by 2 lies in first quadrant. Over.
Whenever x lies in second quadrant means between 90 to 180. Between 90 to 180. X lies in second quadrant, then x by 2 lies in first quadrant.
X by 2 lay in first quadrant. 45 to 90 is in first quadrant only. That is the first information, right? Next, tan x value is equal to 4/3. So this becomes 5. From this diagram, can you tell me what is the value of cos x? Cos x is equal to 3/5 with minus sign.
Cos x value we got -3/5. Yes or no? Cos x is equal to -3/5.
Because x lies in second quadrant. Second quadrant cos is negative. That's why we got -3/5.
But what is asking in the question? Sin x by 2 is asking. Cos x by 2 is asking. Sin x by 2 is asking. Cos x by 2 is asking. If you know sin x by 2, cos x by 2, obviously we can find out tan x by 2, right?
From this, tell me, what is the sin x by 2? Sin x by 2 is equal to plus or minus root of 1 minus cos x divided by 2.
Because the sin square, this 2 will come here. Sin square is that one. Sin x is by 2 is equal to plus or minus.
Therefore, I can write sin x by 2 is equals to root of 1 minus cos x divided by 2. I am taking only plus. Why I am taking only plus?
Sin x by 2 value I am taking only positive. Why? The reason is x by 2 lies in which quadrant? First quadrant. First quadrant, all trigonometric ratios are positive.
That's why I am taking plus only. I am not writing plus or minus. Only plus I am writing. Now what is the value of cos x? Cos x value substitute there. That is equals to root of 1 minus cos x value is -3/5 divided by 2. Right? So that is equals to 8 divided by 10 under root 5 plus 3, 8 divided by 10. Now here we can cancel 2 4s. 2 5s cancel, you will get the answer as 2 divided by root 5. That is the value of sin x by 2. Similarly, we can find out cos x by 2 also. Cos x by 2 also, you will get same plus or minus root of 1 plus cos x divided by 2 from this. Right? But we have to take this one also, root over 1 plus cos x divided by 2 only, plus value only. Why plus value?
Cos x by 2. X by 2 lies in first quadrant. First quadrant, all trigonometric ratios are positive. That's why cos is positive.
X by 2 lies in first quadrant. That's why cos we have taken positive value. In place of cos x, we have to write 1 minus 3/5 divided by 2. That is equals to 1 by root 5. That is cos x by 2, that is sin x by 2. Now we can find out tan x by 2 or not. Sir, why you are finding? I got sin x by 2. From sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. I can find out cos. Yes, you can find out. Okay, there also plus or minus you will get. But we have to consider only plus what. So now I am going to discuss how to find out the value of sin 18 degrees and few other ideas I am going to discuss. All of you pay attention here. So we have to find out the value of sin 18 degrees. That's why I am taking A is equal to 18 degrees. A is equal to 18 degrees means I am taking A is equal to pi by 10 I am taking. And A is equal to pi by 10 means I can write 5A is equal to 90 or not. 5A is equal to 90. Now what I am doing, observe here. 3A is equals to 90 minus 2A. Both sides apply cos. then what we will get? Cos 3a is equals to cos 90 minus 2a. You know cos 3a formula, 4 cos cubed a minus 3 cos a. That is the formula for cos 3a. Now cos 90 minus theta is equal to sin theta. That's why you are getting sin 2a. Now here if you take cos a common, then we will get 4 cos square a minus 3 you will get is equals to this side what happens? 2 times sin a into cos a. Both sides cos a cancel. That means cos a cancel means cos a is equal to 0. Cos a is equal to 0 means a is equal to 90 degrees, which is not possible. That is our answer. Cos a cancel. You are taking cos a is equal to 0. Just observe here. I am taking what happens? Shift to this side. Cos a into 4 cos square a minus 3. Right? Minus 2 times sin a into cos a is equal to 0. Shifted to this side, equal to 0. Now if you take cos a common, what happens? If you take cos a common, you will get 4 cos square a minus 3 minus 2 times sin a is equal to 0. This product is equal to 0 means, this product is equal to 0 means, either this is equal to 0 or this is equal to 0, but this is never equals to 0. Why? A is equal to 18 degrees. Cos 18 not 0. Cos 90 is 0. Cos 18 is not equal to 0. That's why the only possibility is 4 cos square A minus 3 minus 2 sin A must be equal to 0. That we can write it as 4 minus 4 sin square A minus 3 minus 2 sin A is equal to 0. I converted the equation in terms of sin. Cos square A can be written as 1 minus sin square A. Now shift to this side. 4 times sin square A. 4 times sin square A plus 2 times sin A minus 1 is equals to 0. From this I can write sin A is equal to minus B plus or minus square root of B square minus 4 into A into C divided by 2A. It is a quadratic equation in sin A. That's why sin A is equal to minus B plus or minus square root of B square minus 4AC by 2A. So now from this we can write sin A is equals to minus 2 plus or minus root over 4 4s are 16 plus 4 20. 20 can be written as 4 into 5 divided by 2 into 4. Now 4 will come outside, becomes a 2. 2, 2, 2 cancel. So we are getting sin A is equals to minus 1 plus or minus root 5 divided by 4. Array, we got sin A value. Sin A value is equal to minus 1 minus root 5 divided by 4. The other value is minus 1 plus root 5 divided by 4. This is not possible. Why? A is equal to 18 degrees. Sin 18 degrees. 18 degrees is in first quadrant. First quadrant, all trigonometric ratios are positive. Sin also positive. That's why sin 18 degrees, you will get positive only. That's why we can say finally, sin 18 degrees is equals to root 5 minus 1 divided by 4. That is the same as cos 72 degrees. Sin 18 degrees value is the same as cos 72 degrees. In a similar way, I hope so, you can find out the value of cos 18 also. Array, cos square 18 can be written as 1 minus sin square 18. Therefore, cos 18 degrees is equals to root over 1 minus root 5 minus 1 divided by 4 whole square. Right? So from this you will get cos 18 degrees value. Cos 18 degrees value is the same as sin 72 degrees value. So sin 18, cos 18 values. You have to remember for objective exam. For subjective exam, how we are getting those values also, you have to know. That is about sin 18 degrees and cos 18 degrees value. So one more question I am discussing here. This is the question: sine theta into sine 60 minus theta into sine 60 plus theta. Sine theta into sine 60 minus theta into sine 60 plus theta is equals to 1 by 4 into sine 3 theta. Observe here, this LHS we can write it as sine theta into sine a plus b into sine a minus b is equal to sine square a minus sine square b. Sine a plus b into sine a minus b formula, check it. Sine a plus b into sine a minus b is equals to sine square a minus sine square b. Sine a plus b into sine a minus b formula, sine square a minus sine square b. That's why this we can write it as sine theta into sine 60 is equal to root 3 by 2 whole square minus sine square theta. Now that is equals to sine theta into 3 by 4 minus sine square theta. Now sine theta multiply inside, it becomes 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta divided by 4. 3 minus 4 sine square theta divided by 4 sine theta multiplied inside. That is equals to 1 by 4 into sine 3 theta. 1 by 4 into sine 3 theta. So last question I am discussing here. That is the question based on transformations. So this is the question: sine 2a plus a sine 2b plus a sine 2c is equals to 4 times sine a into sine b into sine c. Sine 2a plus sine 2b plus sine 2c is equal to 4 sine a sine b sine c. So first of all, I am taking the left hand side. What is the formula for sine c plus sine d? Sine c plus sine d formula, 2 times sine c plus d divided by 2 into cos c minus d divided by 2 plus sine 2c. Here I applied sine c plus sine d formula, 2 sine c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d by 2. Right? Now again observe here. This we can write it as 2 times sine of a plus b into cos of a minus b plus sine 2c. We can write it as 2 sine c cos c. And here sine c is there. 2 sine c is there. Here also if 2 sine c, then 2 sine c, 2 sine c, sine c will get a common. That's why we have to think in the direction. How to get 2 sin c common? Yes, it is in a triangle ABC. In a triangle ABC, sum of the angles is equal to 180. Therefore, A plus B is equal to 180 minus C. Therefore, we can write sin A plus B is equal to sin 180 minus C. Sin 180 minus theta is sin theta. That's why in place of sin A plus B, sin A plus B we can write sin C. So, this is equals to 2 times sine c into cos of a minus b plus again here we can write 2 times sine c into cos c. Now you can take 2 sine c common. If you take 2 sine c common, we will get cos of a minus b plus cos c. Again cos c we got. So observe here, both sides if you apply cos of a plus b is equal to cos 180 minus c. What about cos 180 minus c? Cos 180 minus c is equal to minus cos c. That's why in place of cos c, in place of cos c, we can write minus cos a plus b. That's why this is equals to 2 times sin c into cos of a minus b. In place of cos c, we can write minus cos of a plus b. cos a minus b minus cos a plus b, that is equals to 2 sin c into cos a minus b minus cos a plus b is equals to, the formula is 2 sin a into sin b, 2 sin a sin b, right? 2 sin a sin b. This we can write it as 4 times sin a into sin b into sin c. That's what we have to prove. Okay, so that is the information here we proved. So trigonometry is completely depends on the formulas. You must be thorough with the formulas. How effectively you know the formulas, that much effectively we can do the problems. Okay, practice more and more. Whenever you are going through the video lecture, means you must note down the points there. Okay, bye bye.